My name's Arthur Tchetchenian. I'm the National Credit Manager of 20th Century Fox. I work for Harper Entertainment, which is a division of HarperCollins Publishing. When I got here, the DSOs, the day sales outstanding, were shocking. They were, you know, somewhere in the 65, 70 days. Time lags with delivery of invoices and statements. Secondly, there was a lack of payment options. There was somewhere between, when I first started here, it was 18 to 20% of our payments were by check. Maybe 75, 80% of our customers were paying by EFT. There was no credit card payment option. The mums and dad owners that own video stores like Video Easy, Blockbuster, Civic, they're not there running the store. They own that as an investment. They've got managers running the store and they do the accounts, you know, after hours or on weekends. They wanted a mechanism or a platform where they could go in there through the internet and do their own and become a little bit more self-sufficient. It was quite an easy decision internally from our management structure at that point to look at all the proposals and to eliminate three straight away and say, well, no, this is the product for us. A little bit unheard of in our organisation. But this really was just, it was a no-brainer. Efficiency, effectiveness, cost effective, easy to implement, and even post implementation, easy to have the files transferred. All that functionality compared to any other system that we saw, the IP payment solution, hands down, was the most effective and the most easy to use for our customers. There are other products on the market. Every bit of development that had to be built around that product was, because it was an outsourced company that was going to do the development, was going to cost us an arm and a leg. So by the time we finished, it was going to be five or six times more expensive and not as effective as what the IP payment solution was. Yeah, we signed the requirements document and we implemented from start to finish. We went go live in about 10 weeks, which is, you know, the alternative that we were looking for, which is the bank product that we would have most likely gone with because it is our bank. That's the News Limited organization's corporate bank. Gave us an implementation of 6 months. So, and it was going to be five times more expensive and not as effective. So if I'm comparing apples and apples, 10 weeks was a massive success. We mapped out the documents, the credit notes, the formatting of the credit notes, the formatting of the invoices, the formatting of the statements. And we were able to send those off so the IP payment developers can start work on that. Our IT department started putting the headers and the footers and all the details together, and we sent that across. The upfront development was so good, and such care was taken in the first round. There wasn't a lot of things we had to do in the second round. All the functionality, you know, printing, downloading, saving invoices and credits and statements, and making payments by EFT and credit card, having a set and forget and direct debits, all the things that make IP payments wonderful. We tested all of that. We then went and saw all the rental group head offices at Blockbuster and Video Easy and Civic, and being the main ones, and gave them a presentation of the site, what it can do, and the functionality. They got really excited about it. We went live in 10 weeks. We sent out another letter to all our customers with their usernames and passwords, again, that IP Payments helped our system generate, with a list of all the benefits to them. We were getting a number of these franchisees across various groups come to us and say, this product's fantastic, it's exactly what we were looking for, I can do this at any time of the day and night, I've become a lot more self-sufficient, all the information I need is there, I don't have to ring up anymore and find out if a credit's been there, or I could do a log on online because it's real time, and I, you know, it saves me phone calls and chasing and running around. The happiest people have been our customers. They're the ones that have really enjoyed having this system available. They're the ones that have truly embraced this. they are your harshest critics. If they don't think that that solution is any good, they just won't use it. So to have almost 50% of our rental customers sign on and use this on a month, on a every month basis, speaks volumes. It's been well embraced. It's been a fantastic product. It's really driven a lot of the customer satisfaction that we'd hope for. You know, we not only achieved a DSO benefit of 11.2 days, but the most significant benefit and what we hope to deliver were things like 15 to 20% of our customers were paying by check. Seen as a shift now of 3% of our customers paying by check, and 90% of our customers now from 80% are paying by EFT. Our inbound calls have dropped by 40%, which means that my credit officers can now get on with doing other things that they used to be bogged down with, trying to resolve customers' issues while they were on the phone. It's less calls they've got to make because only 3% of the customers are paying by check. So follow-up calls for check-paying customers has significantly reduced. But the biggest benefit to us has been the cash flow. The 0708, we added $42 million in addition to what we'd forecasted in cash flow. And 0809, although we factored in the extra money that we would get because of this site, we still delivered an extra $23 million on the cash flow forecast. My finance director at Fox has been getting big pats on the back as a result. The success of this product was so significant that we fast-tracked the replication of this and implemented this into the HarperCollins publishers side. In an ailing industry, the books industry is very, they don't like change, they're adverse to it. And it already in the first 6 weeks, the uptake has been so significant that again, it's caught everybody off guard. They've loved the feedback they're getting from their customers is, why didn't we have this 5 years ago? So in 6 months' time, we won't be using the ERP system we've got. We'll be going on to something else. It was a no-brainer. It was just straight away. Everyone was said, yep, running parallel to the delivery of the new system. One of the things that has to happen is the mapping of IP payments. And that coming from an IT director who never walks towards an implementation, because he knows that the success has been so great, I don't think he wants the owners of these rental channels to ring him up and say, what are you doing? To take that away, I think, would be catastrophic. So again, that speaks volumes that we're all prepared to redo this implementation 2 years later, again, because if we ever took this away from the rental channel, someone's headed wrong. They would be very, very unimpressed.